Good afternoon, students. Now we will start our second chapter, that is control and coordination. The working of various body parts for appropriate reaction to a stimulus is called as control and coordination. That means various body parts will react to the certain stimulus. Such reactions are called as control and coordination. We all respond to light, touch, heat and cold. Not only animals, plants also respond to the stimulus. All these processes conducted in our body by one system, that is nervous system. So nervous system is having one structural and functional unit, that is called as neuron. In our body there are presence of neurons everywhere. The tip of a neuron is called as dendrite. The dendrites have receptors. These receptors collect the information of light, heat, cold and touch. These informations, due to chemical reactions, they are converted into electrical impulses. That means the dendrites of a neuron will collect the information and these will continuously send these informations to the receptors. These receptors collect the information of light, heat, cold and touch. These informations, due to the chemical reactions which is taking place in a cell, they are converted into electrical impulse. These electrical impulse travels from dendrite to the cell body. That cell body pass on these informations to axon. By the axon, informations travel to our brain and it responds back to the reaction. The electrical impulses reaches brain. Hence, thinking is involved in this process. Another process is there where thinking is does not involved. That is called as reflex action. Reflex action do not involve thinking. Hence, it is quicker than normal functioning of a neuron. When we touch any hot material, we take back our hand from it. In this process, thinking is not involved. If thinking involved in this action, then electrical impulse first goes to brain and brain respond to the muscle cells and then muscle cells physically responds. This process is not quick. It may cause effect to our body. As reflex action do not involve thinking, there is a change in functioning of neuron. In reflex action, the neuron is directly connected to muscle nerve, which responds without thinking. That way, it is very quick. This action is called as reflex arc. The connection between the neuron and muscle nerve is situated in the spinal cord. The information in the spinal cord are transferred to brain. Before that, our muscle cells physically respond. This all process is very quick. The process here, the combination of spinal cord and brain is known as central nervous system. It is also known as CNS. When muscles are included in the central nervous system, it becomes peripheral nervous system and also known as PNP, that is peripheral nervous system. Okay, so let us move on to the next topic, that is structure of human brain. So structure of human brain, it contains so many parts, so such as cerebrum, cranium, midbrain, spinal cord, cerebellum, medulla, pons, pituitary gland, hypothalamus, forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain, etc. Understood? Now, let us know about the structure of human brain. It has three main parts. They are forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. First one is forebrain. It contains cerebrum. So, cerebrum is a main thinking part of a brain. It contains sensory areas which receives the electrical impulse from neuron. It has motor areas which gives instructions to the muscles. Second one is midbrain. Midbrain controls the reflex movements of a head, neck and trunk. Third one is hindbrain. The hindbrain has three areas. First one, cerebellum. It maintains the coordination and posture of our body. Second one is pons. It regulates the respiration. Third one is medulla. It controls the activities like swallowing, coughing and sneezing. Brain is very important coordinating part in our body. It protected in a very hard shell. Our head has hard and bumping structure. Before the head, it protects our spinal cord. Moving chair, other involuntary actions controlled by the midbrain and hindbrain. All actions such as BP, salivation, vomiting controlled by the medulla in hindbrain. The activities like walking, riding bicycle, picking up pencil, these are possible due to the part of a hindbrain called as cerebellum. Understood?